So something we didn't really get into with Shane, the only thing I wanted to say it, and then I guess I forgot, was Nick Diaz might come back.
Well, yeah.
We touched on it, but we didn't. Yeah, he wants to fight Jorge.
I know, I said that.
I know, but we didn't go too into detail on it. Like, what do you think of that? Do you think he... It seems like, so 2020, we have two of the biggest stars ever in MMA, Conor McGregor and Nick Diaz, and even Nate Diaz all want to fight Jorge Masvidal. So who do you think gets that fight in 2020? I feel like they're not going to give it to Nick. They should, but they're not going to. Or Conor. I feel like the UFC is going to let this thing like run dry on them, and they're going to have Jorge fight Usman Covington winner, which isn't the best. I mean, realistically, it's not the best fight for him.
I agree.
You know what I mean? That's the blueprint.
It's the toughest fight for him.
Both of those guys are going to grind him out. Crotch sniff, whatever you want to call it. They're going to throw a two-piece and
then
take
him
down.
You know who else was going to grind him out?
Askren.
Yeah.
But they both have way better stand-up than Askren. So where Askren was like, I'm shooting at the bell because I don't want to stand up with this guy, Usman and Covington will be like, all right.
Well, no. He didn't shoot at the bell because he shot the bell because that's like a natural instinct if you run on a wrestler from the level change to take you down.
Yes.
That's a natural instinct.
Yes, but if you look at the other fight that he had against Robbie Lawler, he shot immediately on Robbie Lawler. Like as soon as the bell rang and they walked out, he shot right in and then went for like a drag bar.
Well, that's also like a, you know, throw you off. Walk straight up, you standing straight up, and then instantly level change and... Because that's a very uncommon thing in fighting. Yeah. Usually there's like this feel-out process with let's touch, let's set the strike up versus like just go for it.
As a huge fight fan, I
For example, like in a wrestling match, like whistle blows and guys shoot on the whistle. It's kind of one of those.
Yeah, but as a fight fan, I want to see the money fights. I want to see them do something with Masvidal right now. And they have the rematch with Nate Diaz, which I think he wins.
No, I don't think the rematch is a real thing. Actually, it does have... It does have wings to potentially fly.
Yeah, but apparently, well, last week he said no now, but last week Nate made it like he retired, said I'm like peace out fight game, and then a couple days ago he said, I'll fight tonight. I'm good. I'm not retiring. Where'd you get that from? It's like,
were you smoking the devil's lettuce? And
yeah,
then
were you high tweeting? Were you high when you wrote this? Mm. But and then Nick Diaz did an interview with Helwani, and he was like, Dana White, it's on you. I'm back in 2020 if you want me. It's on you. And then he was like, did you see any of the clips of it?
No, I don't watch Wani. I only watch the mess.
Or any highlights? Oh, of course, but I watch everything. But then he said, he's like, you don't talk about, remember how I said the only negative things said between them were Nate said that whatever, the fight was stopped too early and that he still wanted to fight or whatever. And then Jorge said, I didn't baptize him. So
right.
I want to run this back. Nick was like, you don't talk about baptizing my little brother. That's where he pissed Nick Diaz off.
Okay.
And he was like, that's my baby brother. Nobody's baptizing him. You don't talk about baptizing my little brother. So I want, and he was pretty much like, so I want to fight your fucking ass. So I think if, and they, UFC flirted with that fight, I believe earlier this year maybe, or last year, and they put out like a poster and whatnot, like that was going to be one of the fights. Nick Diaz versus Jorge Masvidal. I think they pull the trigger on that, or they pull the trigger on Conor versus Jorge. And Conor hasn't fought in a minute. Nick hasn't fought in a minute. The worst thing you're doing there is giving one of those guys a loss and building up Jorge Masvidal.
Right.
Or one of those guys win, and then you build them into a superstar.
You know what builds even more superstardom is like Masvidal, and you get the most out of it. Masvidal fights Nate again, wins, and then, like, no one beats up my brother. Now you got to try and beat me. Fights him. Like, that's a big build-up right there.
Yeah. That would build it up even more.
Right.
But then they have it right now. That Nick Diaz was like, I don't do interviews, but I want to do an interview. He had AJ Agarzam contact Helwani, and they put it together to where he went in and sat down with them and was like, you know.
Oh, in New York.
In New York.
Wow.
It's funny because if you read like the comments, because obviously I like reading comments on shit, people were saying like, there's a drinking game in this interview. Every time he says, you know, like, you know what I mean? He just kept saying like, well, you know what I mean? And like pretty much made no sense. Like you have to like watch the interview like three or four times to make sense of what Nick Diaz was saying.
Huh.
Yeah, he was all over the place. But the
Well, I'm sure he came on pretty emotionally.
Yeah, the gist of it was he wants to fight Jorge Masvidal. He said 2020, he's back, wants to fight Jorge Masvidal. I don't even think he said another name. He just said Jorge Masvidal. And then there's a funny thing, like people were saying, because there was definitely some edits in it, but at one point he starts talking about everybody being on steroids, and then it like cuts to a completely different conversation. He definitely went on a rant and was like, you know, started probably naming names and talking mad shit.
Damn.
Yeah. But
so, what does Stan the Man want to see out of all these fights?
I would love to see, like I said, I want to see.
So Kobe and Usman are already, it's going down. Who do you want to see Conor fight?
Perfect world. This is what I want to happen. This is what would happen in my like perfect fight world.
Let's see it, Stan.
Conor McGregor or Nick Diaz fight Jorge Masvidal. I don't think either one of them win that fight, even though I would like to see Nick win that fight. I don't think either one of them win that fight. So Conor McGregor or Nick Diaz fight Jorge. If Jorge wins and Covington wins, then they do that fight. Mm. If Jorge beats either one of them, he fights the other one he didn't fight. Or he fights Nate again, you know, something like that. I feel like they should keep the BMF belt going. I mean, I know Jorge said he wants a title shot or wants the 170-pound belt. That's a tough fight for him either way. I mean, there's no easy fights for him at this point. But
right. Go yeah, they're all tough fights.
Yeah, I want the money fight. I want to see Conor use his stardom and build up another guy, or Conor fucking land that left hand and walk on, make it like he could walk on water again. Khabib said that Conor needs to win 10 fights in a row.
Yeah, I saw that.
Which isn't even possible. That's not going to happen. So he's pretty much saying, like, I will never agree to fight you unless the UFC, I guess, forces his hand. But I wouldn't mind seeing Usman, Covington fight a war and maybe Covington win, and then I think Masvidal versus Covington's a really good fight. Fan-wise, like selling-wise, entertainment-wise, I feel like Usman versus Masvidal is not as entertaining as of a build-up and maybe not even as entertaining of a fight. Like, I think Usman could easily five-round him.
Well, I mean, there's, you know, there is footage of Kobe following Usman around and, you know, their manager's almost getting fights and, you know, Kobe coming to Usman's, like...
There's a fight.
Fight warm-ups. I mean, they've got footage to promote this. And make
Yeah. They have a fight in the buffet line of them, like, swinging at each other.
Yes.
Yeah. Which is, you know, more banter. You gave Kobe ammunition. Kobe's like, you claim like you were hurt. You jumped out of your wheelchair to try to fight me in the buffet line.
Yeah.
You and your sleazebag manager. Yeah, they got a lot of shit to sell there, but...